school.
I have lived a life of sin in this world I'm living in. I have done forbidden things I shouldn't do. I ask a beggar along the way if he could tell me where to stay, where I could find real happiness and love that's true. Across the bridge, there's no more sorrow. Across the bridge, there's no more pain. The sun will shine across the river, and you'll never be unhappy again. Footsteps of the King, till you hear the voices ring, they'll be singing out the glory of the land. The River Jordan will be near, the sound of trumpets you will hear, and you'll behold the most precious place ever known to man. Across the bridge, there's no more sorrow. Across the bridge, there's no more pain. The sun will shine across the river, and you'll never be unhappy again. Across the bridge, there's no more sorrow. Across the bridge, there's no more pain. The sun will shine across the river, and you'll never be unhappy again.
Look what you're going to do now.
Papa.
I have lived a life of sin in this world I'm living in. I have done forbidden things I shouldn't do. I ask a beggar along the way if he could tell me where to stay, where I could find real happiness and love that's true. Across the bridge,
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Okay, say a hearty good evening to everyone. Good evening. Okay, and welcome to the funeral of a late Everod Ramdeen. Okay, I'm here just to open the word of prayer. And let's pray and ask the Lord's blessing on our coming together. Our gracious Father, we bless your holy name. We thank thee, O God, for thy greatness. We thank thee, O loving Father, that thou art the one who had created us. Thou art the one, O gracious God, who had made us. And so this evening, we commit this funeral service into your hand. We thank thee, Lord, that to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And so, gracious Father, we ask your blessings upon this service this evening. We commit all at this time into your hand, and we pray, O gracious God, that thou will give them the comfort that comes from thyself. We thank thee that thou art our great comforter. And so, loving Father, we continue, O God, to bless your holy name. O precious Father, we pray for the service this evening, that thou would bless everything that will be said and done. We pray for our pastor, that thou will continue to bless him and use him, O God. And to your honor, your praise, and your glory. So, our loving Father, this evening, we pray that the message this evening will reach the hearts of those who may not know thee. And so, Lord, that they may come to know thee, whom is life eternal, because thou art the one who are alive today. So, gracious God, we just commit everything into your hand and pray, dear Father, that thou, O God, will take charge from first to last as we ask these things in the wonderful name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Over now to Pastor Ramson.
All right. Praise the Lord. Thank you so much, Pastor. And a warm welcome to each and everyone. We thank God for, the Bible says, in everything to give thanks. We don't understand it, but it says in everything to give thanks, because this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. It would seem as if human beings will never get accustomed to death and funeral, but death is a part of life. And the scripture says it is appointed unto man once to die, and after death is a judgment. This evening we are gathered here to celebrate the life of Everod Ramdeen, affectionately known as Brother Boy. And I thank God for knowing this man since school days. You see my hair, so that's a long time. And we have been friends so many years. And recently, sometime last year, we were having some house meetings in Pinto Road, not too far from his house. And he and his darling wife and their grand would come over to the house and fellowship. And then he asked me to have a Thanksgiving at his house. And he wanted to come to church and all of that. But I thank God that he accepted the Lord. His big brother was there, and he accepted the Lord. And I know, I have no doubts in my mind, as long as we accept the Lord Jesus Christ, we don't have to worry. Amen? So we thank God for each and every one of you that came out this evening to support the family, to comfort the family. And those of you who would have known Boy, you are here in honor of this man. We give God thanks for that. Amen? So right now, we just want to do a little worship, praise and worship, and I want to ask you to stand with us, please. as we honor God. I have with me Sister Melissa Ramkisun, who will be doing the worship for us.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Good evening, everyone. Condolences to friends and family of the deceased. Hallelujah. There's a song that says, "How great is our God." Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. My mind to go God's way in the rest of my life. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. Goodbye world, I stay no longer with you. Goodbye pleasures of sin, I stay no longer with you. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. I made up my mind go God's way the rest of my life. Sing Jesus' name so sweet, Emmanuel name so sweet. Jesus' name so sweet, Emmanuel name so sweet. talk about Jesus. Jesus' name so sweet. Everybody walk and talk about Jesus. Jesus' name so sweet. Sing Jesus' name so sweet. Emmanuel name so sweet. Jesus' name so sweet. Emmanuel name so sweet. Everybody walk and talk about Jesus. Jesus' name so sweet. Everybody walk and talk about Jesus. Jesus' name so sweet. Sing goodbye world. I stay no longer with you. Goodbye pleasures of sin. I stay no longer with you. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. Sing goodbye world.
Praise the Lord. You may have your seats, beloved. Thank you so much for bearing with us. I know it's a sad time, but for the child of God, it's a rejoicing time. The Bible says, how beautiful in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his saints. And I know that boy is rejoicing with the Lord. When a child of God, you know, we sing the song, when we all get to heaven, wow. And I know it's sad for the family. It's a grieving time, but it's a rejoicing time also when we know that one has gone to be with the Lord. Amen? To be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And at this time, we have a special, and it's the person that was supposed to do that special, sad to say they are not too well, so I've asked Sister Melissa to do this song, The Goodness of God. God has been good. God has been good. We are here this evening because of the goodness of God. And for those of us who knew Boy, we knew who Boy was. And we knew that Boy was not well for many years, but yet he was faithful. He was courageous. He extended his love and his appreciation and his goodness to all that came in contact with him. And so we know that God has been good to Boy and to his family. So we want to do this song, The Goodness of God.
Hallelujah. Okay. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I love you, Lord, for your mercy never fails me. I've been held in your hands from the moment that I wake up till I lay my head. I will sing of the goodness of God. 'Cause all my life you have been faithful. Goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire. In darkest nights, you were close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend. And I have lived in the goodness of God. 'Cause all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every of the goodness of God. Oh, I'm gonna sing of the goodness of God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Our God is a faithful God. He's a good God. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Right now, we will have a video tribute to Boy. Amen.
I have lived a life of sin in this world I'm living in. I have done forbidden things I shouldn't do. I ask a beggar along the way if he could tell me where to stay, where I could find real happiness and love that's true. Across the bridge, there's no more sorrow. Across the bridge, there's no more pain. The sun will shine across the river, and you'll never be unhappy again. Footsteps of the King, till you hear the voices ring, they'll be singing out the glory of the land. The River Jordan will be near, the sound of trumpets you will hear, and you'll behold the most precious place ever known to man. Across the bridge, there's no more sorrow. Across the bridge, there's no more pain. The sun will shine across the river, and you'll never be unhappy again. Across the bridge, there's no more sorrow. Across the bridge, there's no more pain. The sun will shine the river, and you'll never be unhappy again.
Look what you're going to do now.
Praise the Lord. Thank you so much. Across the bridge. No more sorrow. No more sickness. No more crying. No more pain. We will be happy forever and ever. Amen. On this side of the bridge, oh boy. Too much, too much, too much. Especially these days. But I want us to know that the days will not get better. I am not a prophet of doom, but the Bible says that in the last days, perilous times shall come. Some of us live as if we will live 100 years and more. But beloved, no man knoweth the hour when their life would be gone. It's an appointment that we have to keep. We have to keep it. Let us live each day as if it's the last. Because we don't know when we leave. Amen? But one thing we know, when we live righteous, when we live for the Lord, when we do what is right, we will cross the bridge. And over there, no more sorrows, no more pain. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Right now, we want to have the eulogy. by Abigail Moreno. Let's welcome Abigail as she comes, please. Yes. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. You all hearing me? The eulogy of Everod Ramdeen. Everod Ramdeen, known as Boy to friends and family, was born to Hilda Ramdeen and Paul Mills, deceased, on the 13th March 1959, brother to 7 sisters and 2 brothers. Boy, with his sense of humor, had a nickname for everyone. For example, the nickname Coochie Boy for his favorite nephew, Kevin. Kevin was somewhat of his eyeball when he was younger. Boy would always pick up for him, no matter what he did. While having a great sense of humor, he still maintained a level of seriousness, especially when it came to his favorite sport, cricket. He loved and enjoyed watching the game. England was his favorite team and never missed a match. It's to see his action when he's taking in a game, the excitement when his team is winning. He also loved football, and of course, his side was the England team. And with that, he got the nickname, the Englishman. Boy also loved playing dominoes with his friends, Marvin, Terrence, and Mr. Kiwi. Mr. Kiwi was his best pal, and together they were called Bim and Bam. If there was an argument between the two, and Mr. Kiwi didn't visit Boy for a while, Boy would send Terrence to look for him and bring him back. That was a great friendship. Boy was known for loving great tasting food. Don't give him that food without flavor or salt. He won't eat it. There are many stories to tell of Boy in his younger days. But one story stood out with his siblings, remembering that at 6 years old, he took a penny from his mom. And not for nothing, he would give it back, saying he never took it while holding on to his pocket. Well, that sold him out. And he got a good, His granddaughter, Elaine, was his special love of his life. Elaine gave Boy the strength, care, and love to have life as long as he did during his 14 years of his illness. He was a loving husband to Rose and caring father to Ronnie, who would take his father with him to all his games. I'm sure all of us has a memory or a funny story with Boy. Too many to mention. He was a husband, father, grandfather, uncle to so many of us, brother and special friend. He will surely be missed. We love you, Everod Ramdeen, better known to all of us as Uncle Boy. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. Well done, Abigail. Well done. Amen. Boy lived a full life. He lived a full life. And God saw it fit to call him home. Amen. He went through a lot. And like I said, from sometime last year when I reconnected really close with Boy, and he would relate to me all that happened to him over the last few years, Boy was a source of encouragement to me. And I always shared that. I always testified of that. I said there are so many people who are healthy, have all their members functioning properly, and they wouldn't, you know, go to the house of God to give thanks. But boy, he was willing to come. He was willing to come to any house meeting that is close by. We know, I mean, I could talk about it because boy, he wasn't ashamed about it. A man with a catheter would be ashamed. But boy, he came to church. And that encouraged me. Sometimes, if rain falls, we don't want to go to church. Speaking to the people who consider themselves Christians. But this man with his wife will find themselves there in the meetings. And that encouraged me. That I will never forget that. I will never forget that. I have learned to observe things and people and words and what have you. And that encouraged me even to this day. And it will always stay as an encouragement to my life. When people in a situation can stand up and do what is right. They could make all kinds of excuses like we do. But he stood up for God, and I appreciate that. And that's a source of encouragement. He had the grace of God upon his life and the love of God. And I thank God. I feel honored and privileged to be doing what I'm doing now. When I heard that he passed, I got the call. I went straight to the house, and I spoke with his darling wife, his son, his families, all the families were there. And I told her that anything that I can do to help, please let me know. She said, Pastor, boy, say, Pastor Ramzan, that is who would let him do everything. And you know, I feel honored about that, that we reconnected and that boy considered me. I didn't even know that. But it's not about me. It's about the love of God in our lives. We must show love. Sometimes we want to be loved, but we must show love. We must express love, not just in words, but in deeds. Amen? I know we have some time still, and I want to do something that is not on the program. I want to invite at least two people. I know he has two brothers here. At least one of them and some other person to come for just 2 minutes and give a tribute in honor of the life of boy. Let's do it quickly, please. At least two people who would come. Be brave enough. You know, sometimes we want to talk about people after they die, but it's quite all right. Come and share something. Maybe some, it might be fun or whatever, but it will encourage us, even as Abigail shared certain things that fun and we laughed and what have you, but we knew that is boy. So anybody want to come now and share with us just for like 2 minutes? Big Brother Kelvin.
Good evening to everyone. Yeah. Hear me? I want to say, my brother, he was truly a role model. And you know, when I used to visit him, not so very often, and we always used to talk, and sometime when he got mangoes, have mango trees under my him. The only time sometimes I'll see him is when he comes to bring mangoes for me. And not only that, I don't want to forget, not only that, sometimes his wife make roti. And anything she make, you know, she will send some. She will tell my brother, boy, go and bring some for him, for Kelvin. And I appreciate that, you know, and we go a long way, you know. That's my last brother. But he was ailing for some time, and I used to go and pray for him, pray for the family. Sometimes, Pastor Ramzan, you know, we come sometimes not together, but he passes and pray for him and his family. And one day I went there, and he sat down on his little sofa there, and we talked, and I prayed for him. And I remember I saw tears coming down boy's eyes. And I said, you know, boy, I would like you to know the Lord Jesus Christ. And he said, Kelvin, I'm ready to give my heart to the Lord. And I prayed for him. And he confessed his sin before God. And he was saved. And I believe he is just absent from this body, present with the Lord. And I want to say thank you for Boy. And I pray, I hope that, you know, his name will never be forgotten. And so, this is the last show now. We would not see him again. But those who accept him, I believe that they will see him in time to come. So thank you very much.
Amen. Praise the Lord. That is great news. We heard it straight from the mouth. That is the man that led his brother to the Lord. Amen. And let me tell you this. God is the ultimate judge. You know, we make judgments, but we are human beings. We make errors. We make mistakes. God don't make any mistake at all. And God will have mercy upon whom he will. Wish to God we were as merciful as God is. Hallelujah. But I thank God for that witness. If anything else, if nothing else, remember that boy accepted the Lord. And that is the greatest news. All the nice food and all the mango and all of you, that is fun. That is nice. But that he accepted the Lord is the most important thing he ever did in his life. And we give God thanks this evening. Anybody else want to come quickly, please? Come their heart.
I want to say a blessing in the name of Jesus to each and everyone who is here today. I just want to thank everybody for coming out today to, you know, send my brother off, you know, to meet the Lord with love in their heart. You know, I have many things to say about Boy. We were young growing up. I was just the second child under Boy. So I have a lot of experience growing up with Boy. Many, many things I could say about Boy. How we were, you know. My mother died when we were a young age, and we learned to cook. And Boy was never happy with the food. He always complained, I never see, you know, fine leaf thyme with a long stem. And he would say, take it off the food. You know, he was so that type of a person who liked everything to be in order. You know, I want to say that I am grieving in my heart even the moment I heard my brother passed away. Because I came to Trinidad and I never get to see my brother. And he was hurt so badly. It's not because I didn't get to go. I didn't go purposely to see him. It's because the time was so quick that I did not get the time to go and visit him. But you know, I have so much great things to say about Boy. When my daughter Wendy had her baby in Montauk Hospital, she called me and she said, Mommy, you know who I saw come visit me? She said, Uncle Boy. And he was walking with a cane, you know, like stick. And he came in the hospital and visit my daughter when she had her baby. These are all memory in my heart that I will remember of my brother. And the night that Boy died, I don't know he died, but like 4 a.m, there was so much thunder. Thunder was like, you know, want to break down the house where I live. And I got up, it was like 4 a.m. I told my sister Sandra that I said, you know, Boy is crying. Boy, you know, I start praying. I sat up in my bed and I say, God, remember my brother Boy. I know he was in the hospital. They said, you know, it wasn't looking so good and everything. But I said, God, I know he's crying out to you. And I know that you're hearing him. I said, God, just be with him in any which way, God, the best way that you know that he need to your love and his life and everything, God. And I just offer him up in prayer. And I went to work that day. And while I was working, my sister called me and she said, "Christine, you know he's gone. And there's nothing I could do but just run from where I was." And I was just screaming out. It hit me so hard because I was planning to come back and visit, you know, and see him specifically. But it never happened. But I thank God that I see him here, and I'm happy in my heart to know that he is with the Lord. I never know what Kelvin testified about, all those things, but I believe in my heart that it is true that he gave his life to the Lord. He's a good soul, and he's resting in peace with God right now. Just what I want to say about my brother.
Thank you very much, Pastor. Thank you for having me here. Mr. Pleasant, good afternoon to each and everybody. I was sitting among the family, among the sisters and things, and the brothers there. And tears were hitting me all over. I stand here in sorrow with you. I sympathize very much. Tante Rose, we have a long way to go still. Hallelujah. Have courage and faith. Yes. Believe in him, and he will deal with you. Hallelujah. When I think of Boy, my nephew, we grow a long way together. I am the only uncle they ever recognized, the whole set of them. And the only one standing today. I wouldn't be fitting that I'm sitting here today without coming and say how I am sympathy with you all. It's a set of brothers and sisters, and I want to tell you all, if all you want to know what love is, join the Ramdeen family. Join the Ramdeen family, because they will get together and put things together as you never see before. My wife wants me today to convey to Ronnie how grateful she was for assisting her that night she was in the wake. Rain fell, it was terrible. I was sitting there and I was telling how she getting out of there. And I was frightened because I'm all with a cane. I couldn't, and she was very grateful to you, Ronnie. God bless you. In closing, I want to tell you, with Kiwi, his good friend, and the rest, Boy never lost argument. Never ever lost argument. And if he figure going to lose that argument, he's going to run Kiwi and run everybody from this place. This is the kind of man he was. Right? Boy, may your soul rest in peace. And may God bless you. Time is against me, and I want to be very short. I want to thank you all for coming and supporting us in whatever thing. And may God bless each and every one of us. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. Let's give the Lord a round of applause. Come on. God is good. It is always good to be obedient to the voice of God. You know, sometimes we as preachers and pastors, we feel that, you know, we have a 15 minutes, so we can make much of it. But I told the family when they were preparing the program, this is family time. This is family time. And I knew there was supposed to be a special, a musical, and whatever. But I follow the Spirit of God because the special was kind of canceled. And so I felt led of the Lord to invite the family to come. And so Kelvin shared from his heart what happened. And then this sister that came in. Can you imagine that she would have gone back without saying that from her heart to her brother, even though he's there? But she said it while the body is still here. And I thank God for that. This is about family. Now is family time. Amen? It's not about any personal time. It's family time. And I thank God that they responded. Even our brother came And I wouldn't turn him back. Although I asked for two people, I wouldn't turn him back. And he shared some stuff there. Boy, he never lost an argument. Hallelujah. Now, this evening, I want to share from the Word of God for you just a few minutes. I'm reading from 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, from verse 13 to verse 18. The Apostle Paul writing said, "But I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that you sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, and with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words." Comfort one another with these words. Father, we give you thanks for your word. Bless our hearts this evening, we pray. And backing up to verse 13, the Apostle Paul says that I want you to understand. I don't want you to be ignorant. I don't want you to not know or to live in darkness. But listen, concerning death, brethren, concerning them that are asleep, what lies in that box there is not boy. That is the house that boy lived in. Boy is no longer here. Boy has ascended up to be with the Father. Like we said, to be absent in the body is to be present with the Lord. And so what we gather here this evening is to send the remains of his body into the flames. But the Apostle Paul wants us to understand not to worry, not to sorrow for them, even as others who have no hope. You see, people that don't have hope, people that don't have Jesus, people that don't have the life of God in their lives, well, then they will be sorrowful. They have no hope. But we who have hope, yes, we grieve, but we don't have to sorrow. Some people sorrow to death. Some people grieve to death. Some older folks, when one die, the other one follows soon after because of grief, the pain of grief. But the Apostle Paul is saying that we don't have to sorrow in that way because we have a hope that he will rise. Even when we die, we will live again because of the word of God. He says in verse 14, if we believe that Jesus died, that Jesus rose again, even so also those who sleep in Jesus, just as boy accepted Jesus via his big brother, those who died in Christ, they will rise again, just as Jesus rose from the dead. And the scripture says that God will bring him up to be with God, with Jesus. Not the archangel. He's not even sending Gabriel. He's not sending any other angel. He's not sending anybody else. The Bible says, those that sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. Amen? So know this, that God loves you. God is interested in you while you're alive, and he's interested in you when you die. As a matter of fact, when you die, you're going to be with him as long as you live for Jesus. Amen? Verse 15 says, for this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, not by Pastor Ramzan or a beloved pastor who opened in prayer, or by Pastor Kelvin. Not by any man's word, but by the word of God. This we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive. So even at the coming of Christ, if you are still alive, hear what will happen. We that are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not stop them which have fallen asleep before. We cannot prevent them from going up first, beloved. They have the edge on us. Anyone that remains alive when Jesus come in the clouds, when they shout, when the angels shout, when the trump of God sound, none of us can stop them. The Bible says they will rise first. Amen. For the Lord himself shall come down from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Amen. They shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. Beloved, this is a mighty, great, and precious promise. I don't know about you. When some of us, when we are promised something, man, we will move heaven and earth just to get that promise. I promise you a raise, but you will work extra hours just to get that raise. They promise you to fix the drain, man, you'll be a good boy. They promise to build your house, you will do anything anybody wants just to fulfill a promise. And you know something with us human beings? God has given us so many great and precious promises in his word, and we don't prepare for it. We don't prepare for it. We live any old how, not considering what God has promised to us if we live for him. Amen? And he has promised us that we will be caught up to meet him. If we are dead, we'll be risen first. And if we're alive, we'll be caught up together to meet God in the air, to meet Jesus in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. And again, where the Lord is, there is no sorrow, there is no sickness, there is no more death, no pain, no argument, no quarrel about who burned the roti. Nothing, but only peace, joy, and happiness in the presence of the Lord Jesus Christ. And this is the word. This is the word where the Apostle Paul says, wherefore, in a time like this, read this passage. Read what God has prepared for us. Go back and research it and see what God has blessed us with. This promise that he will take us up even if we die. And if we're alive, we'll be caught up. We won't need a plane ticket. We won't be going up in a plane. We'll be going up in plain air. Amen? So let us live to please God, beloved. You see the hating and the quarreling and the bickering and the backbiting and confusion? Get away from that. Let us learn to love our brother and our sister. Let us learn to love each other. Let us learn to forgive. Some of us, we live, with our own wives, with our own husbands, with our children, with our brothers and sisters, with our friends, with our neighbors. Cat and dog living better than some of us. I want to encourage us this morning. There are great and precious promises in the Word of God. Start to read your Bible, man. And I'm not talking about religion here. We read, anybody read any books, you could take up the Bible and read and see what God has promised us. Even if we die. I shared with a family that the mother lived for God all her life, and she used to always pray for her children. After she died, the children quite a few accepted the Lord before, but those that were outside started coming in and coming to God, because God honors his word. He honors his word above his name. And every promise that he makes to us, he will fulfill it. Even if you die, God will fulfill his promise to you. He promised to save you and to save your household. You may die and go and you may be worrying. Don't worry, man. God will fulfill his word. Amen? His word is yes and amen to those that believe. Believe God. The boy behaving bad, trust God. The girl behaving bad, trust God. Wait and see. Even if you die, God will be, he will honor his word to you because he promises that. Amen? Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. This evening, Sister Rosie and members of the family, we comfort you with the words that boy will rise again. Jesus himself will call boy and he will rise again in that day. And then if we are alive, we will be risen to meet them. The question is, as I close, do you want to see Boye again? All of us here who come this evening to honor the memory of Boye, do you want to see Boye again? Right, good. Well, if you want to see Boye again, do what Boye did. Repent, accept the Lord Jesus Christ, and live for him. Amen, beloved? Father, we give you thanks for your word. We thank you, Lord, for every person that is here. And we pray, oh God, that your word will touch hearts right now. In Jesus' name, let your word find root in hearts, Lord, that people will start to study your word and to pray and to seek your face. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Would you please stand? I want to pray for the family. Hallelujah. I want to pray for the family right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, I lift up the Ramdeen family before you. And even as we send off Boye's body, oh God, we pray for peace. We pray that the peace of God will touch their hearts and their minds. We pray for the comfort of the sweet Holy Spirit to rest and abide with each heart, oh God. Father, in the days and the weeks and the months to come, I pray, oh God, that you will comfort the family members. We pray that your spirit will cover the homes, cover the lives, oh God. Even that little granddaughter, cover her, oh God, in the name of Jesus. We pray your blessing upon them. We pray your spirit will overshadow them right now. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Hallelujah. Just before we close, we will sing that song. Big Brother Kelvin will come and just give a vote of thanks. But before he do, we just commend Boye's body to the elements that it came from, dust to dust, ashes to ashes, in Jesus' name. Come give thanks. And then we'll just sing, Sister Melissa, we'll just sing the chorus of that lovely song, Across the Bridge.
I want to say thanks to everyone for coming. And I want to say most of all, in the time while my brother was ill, I cannot call name because there are so many. It will take from now until to call name. But I want to say thanks to everyone. Thanks for those who look after him. Thanks for his sisters. You know, my sister worked feverishly and to help boy in his illness. And I want to thank her, thank each and every one of them. And I want to thank the friends for being a friend to boy. And they will always come and say, boy, you want this, boy, you want that, boy, you want that, how you're going and things like that. And I just want to thank God for each and every one here. Thank you for all. Thank you for what you have done. And I hope that in the will of the Lord that you may continue to bless his wife, who has not so well also. We ask that the love will continue. God is love and he wants us to love one another. This is what we need for one another. And I want to thank everybody again for what they have done for my brother, Boye, and for what they're going to still do for him, for his wife. So I want to say thank you very much for everything. And thank you again and again.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Pastor Kelvin. Could we come in an orderly manner this way as we sing the chorus Across the Bridge? Amen. Could we come and do the viewing?
The bridge, there's no more sorrow. Across the bridge, there's no more pain. The sun will shine across the river, and you will never be unhappy again. Across the
Place ever known to man. Across the bridge, there's no more sorrow. Across the bridge, there's no more